guys, so in today's video I'm going to be talking about some of the online deals and news going on right now, so let's get into the video. Sadly, there are no new deals right now, like at Vodacom or Cell C or anything, but you can go ahead and look at my previous videos for this month. I did mention a bunch of deals in my previous videos, and there is a playlist, so you can definitely go check that out if you're looking for any new deals on phones or other products. Okay, so we're going to get started with the online deals. And I'm going to start off with Takealot, and they're having a sale on Apple Watch bands that are discounted, and these are discounted for about 50%, 33%, or 45%, and there's also an option for a 57% discounted, so that's really awesome. So definitely go check out Takealot if you want any accessories for your Apple Watch, and I just think this is a really, really great deal. On the iStore, they also had a deal with Vodacom for two iPhone SEs for 549 rand per month. The one is going to be on the YouTube Flexi 200 plan and the other on the YouTube Flexi 110 plan. So this is also really worth it to check out. Also, I really recommend going to check out the Takealot website since they have daily deals which range from different projects like phones or just accessories. So really just go check that out if you're looking for any deals. Okay, so now let's move on to the news side of things. So Microsoft said that they are not going to be focusing on Windows 10 Mobile anymore, so users should not expect any new features or any new hardware on that platform. So we all know that it's the end of Windows 10. Let's just take a moment to digest that. Okay, that's enough. Then MacBear also launched their new Motion smartphone, and this features a IP67 water resistance. It is a mid-range device and it has a 5.5-inch display at 1080p, but I also don't really think this device will make it to South Africa. Then the next big event on the mobile front is Honor sent out invitations for their London launch on the 5th of December. So I'm really excited to see what they have to offer. Okay, so let's move on to Google. Due to a hardware problem, the Google Home Mini was recording all of the audio around it and was sending it to the Google servers. And once they reported this to Google, the company saw that the speaker touch control center was malfunctioning. Google has temporarily disabled that feature. That could have been a bit creepy. Then the very hot news regarding Apple is that Apple and LG are in discussion to see if they can make a foldable OLED screen for iPhones. We know Samsung has been planning on making foldable phones, and now iPhone has also stepped into that, and they're just seeing what they can do. So I don't know if we're going to see this next year, maybe in 2019, but I'm just really excited to see what these companies have to offer. Then I see on the iStore in South Africa, they have updated their home screen as to showing the release date of the iPhone 8. And like I mentioned last weekend, it is on the 20th of October. And they also have the Apple Watch Series 3 on their homepage, which is also going to be releasing on the 20th of October. The Apple Watch Series 3 with the GPS, the 38mm, looks to price around 5,499 Rand, and the 42mm looks to price around 5,999 Rand, but these are not official prices yet. I still don't know if the LTE version of the Apple Watch Series 3 will be coming to South Africa, but I did see on the iStore there's an article explaining messages and phone calls, so who knows, maybe we will see it here in South Africa. That would be really great. So the most exciting news that I have is that the iStore has released the pricing for the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus here in South Africa. And for the iPhone 8, the 64GB option will be 13,499 Rand. And for the 256GB option will be 16,499 Rand. And as for the iPhone 8 Plus, the 64GB option will be 15,499 Rand. And the 256GB option will be 18,499 Rand. So those are the prices for the iPhone 8 and 8 Plus. And I'm really, really excited that they finally released the prices. So I hope those of you who are in the market for an iPhone 8 or 8 Plus are happy with the pricing. I'm just wondering that if the iPhone 8 Plus is going to be about 18,499 Rand, what the price of the iPhone 10 will be. I mean, over 20,000, that's hectic. So next week we'll probably have all the news for the iPhone 8 and the Apple Watch Series 3. Now we just have to wait for all the news and dates for the iPhone 10. Those were all the deals and news I have for you guys this week. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please leave the video a big thumbs up. Comment down below what you think of the pricing of the iPhone 8. Is it too much for you? Or are you still waiting for the iPhone 10? Let me know in the comments down below. And definitely subscribe. I really appreciate that. I will see you guys in my next video. Be weird and be proud of it. Love you guys so much. Bye.